In this video, we'll be checking out the process of using aux buses to set up monitor mixes for the band on stage. Now, aux buses or auxiliary buses are a set of versatile output buses found on almost all mixing consoles, and they can either be configured as pre-fader or post-fader sends. Now, generally, mono pre-fader aux buses are used to send output signals from the mixing console to stage monitors. And stage monitors in this context are the loudspeakers found on stage that the musicians and singers use to hear themselves as well as fellow band members. Pre-fader, on the other hand, means the channel fader does not affect the sound on stage, meaning the mix that is made for the musicians on stage is different and independent of the mix that is made for the audience. So for demonstration, we'll be using the Yamaha MG2414FX mixing console. Now this mixer comes with six auxiliary sends. All six can be configured as post fader sends, and only aux 1 to 4 can be used as pre fader sends. So sound comes to the mixer through the gain and the EQ, and when you press the pre fader buttons, the sound travels along the aux buses to the aux masters and out to the stage monitors. Each aux bus represents a mix that is sent to the musicians' monitors on stage. So for the sake of demonstration, we'll assign the output of aux 1 to the stage monitors feeding the singers, lead vocals and backup singers, and aux 2 will be assigned to the keyboardist, aux 3 will be assigned to the guitarist, bass guitar and lead guitarist, while aux 4 will be assigned to the drummer. And then the first thing is to turn the aux master knobs to the unity gain position, and for this mixer, unity gain is the 3 o'clock position. And then for the channel strips, you need to assign all the channels that need to be sent to the monitors to pre-fader aux sends. And then ask yourself, who needs to hear each individual input? The very first input that is considered when sending channels to the monitor is the lead vocals channel, because everyone needs to hear the lead vocalist. And then from the fact that the lead vocals monitor speaker is the most likely to cause feedback, we need to assign that first and use it as a reference point to be able to set other levels of other input. And so for the lead vocals channel, assuming channel 16 here is the channel for the lead vocalist, to assign the lead vocals channel to his monitor to hear himself, you have to turn up aux 1, having assigned the auxes to pre-fader. To send the lead vocals channel to the keyboardist, turn up aux 2. To send his channel to the monitor used by the guitarist, you turn up his knob in aux 3. I usually turn them up to unity gain, and for the drummer, you turn them up as well. I usually turn them up to unity gain, and then set the monitor amplifier to a point whereby the level is just right without getting any feedback. And then I mix every other source in reference to this. And so if you want to send the backup vocal, for example, let's say 14 and 15, if you want to send the backup vocal to hear himself in his monitor, you turn him up at his monitor. Let's say the keyboardist doesn't need to hear the backup vocals, for example, you don't turn it up. Let's say the other instruments, they don't need to hear the backup vocals, you don't turn them up either. Now there are some instruments that have on stage amplifiers, like the bass guitar and the lead guitar, for example. For those inputs to the mixer, you don't need to send their inputs to any monitor, because they have an on stage amplifier combo which is sufficient to feed them with the sound that they need to hear, as well as other musicians. And also some instruments such as drums that are already acoustically loud on stage, you don't need to feed them to, especially in small venues, you don't need to patch them to any monitor, because everyone can hear the acoustic sound on stage, except maybe in large venues or in venues where the drum is shielded and then it's not loud enough for acoustically for the other musicians to hear. Then you can turn up maybe the snare or the hi-hat or both of them, so that other musicians can be able to maintain tempo and rhythm. Other than that, they are usually turned, their monitor sends are usually down. Now here are a couple of things I'd like to mention with creating monitor mixes for the band on stage. Now the first one is that although monitor mixes are created using pre-fader auxiliary knobs, they are however post EQ and post gain aux sends. What I mean by this is that sound comes into the mixer passing through the gain and the EQ session, and then before going to the auxiliary bus. And so if you make any change to the gain during the event, it will affect the sound on the monitor mix. So you should avoid changing the gain setting after having set up the monitor mix. Any change you need to do should be probably just EQ and the channel fader, so that you won't have your singers and musicians complaining of having an imbalanced mix up on stage. Now, another thing is that because the sound engineer mixes to the audience and really hears what the musicians hear at their monitors, it's important to take some time during sound check to be on stage and actually listen to what the musicians are listening to, so as to be able to make some adjustments to their monitor mixes to really suit them. And it's important also to trust your musicians with their demands. Some musicians can actually make funny requests with what they want on their monitor speakers, but it's especially the experienced ones, it's really important to trust them with their mixes, just how as they trust you, the front of house guy, with the front of house mix. You can also use the AFL buttons to listen to the monitor mixes via your headphones, so as to constantly update yourself with what the musicians are listening to, and it will help you to be able to give them a good mix during the event or the service. And finally, when setting up monitor mixes, it's important to start with the vocal mics and their monitors, because they are the most likely to cause feedback, and then mix every other thing in relation to that. That's all for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any question, you can leave your question in the comment and I'll be more than happy to respond to them. Check out my other video on how to use the EQ session in the mixing console here, and how to set gain on the mixing console right here. Other than that, I'm Kelvin. Thank you for seeing this video. I'll see you in the next one.